Hello, and my name is Alan with Saved by the Geeks, and today I'm going to show you how to create a virtual machine using VMware Player. Now, this is for non-commercial use only, so please, if you plan on using this for commercial or business, you can download or upgrade to the VMware Workstation. It's a great software solution there, so if you have any questions about that, just leave it in the comments below. I'm going to put up the link on your screen to download the VMware Player, or you can go to vmware.com, downloads, and you should see it down at, towards the bottom. Just a couple things with the GUI here. Once you install it, on the left-hand side, you're going to see where all of your existing virtual machines are, and when you highlight them, you'll see the details to the right-hand side. On the right hand side under the home, you're going to have the option to create a new virtual machine, open a virtual machine, upgrade to VM workstation or help. Once again, this is not licensed for commercial, so just keep that in mind. I'm going to go and get that off of there. The first thing to do is we're going to create a virtual machine. This video is going to be fairly quick because it's really easy after you get this far. The main steps are in the beginning, and then it's just like you're actually on a PC, so there's really no need to go into that. So this first option here is going to allow you to select what kind of installation media you'd like to use, whether it be an install disk in one of your drives or a virtual drive, or an ISO image. Now, I love using ISO images. It's easier to do. You can browse the location of it, and you'll be able to install it. Or you can choose to install it later. That's if you want to make some different changes to the settings. But we're just going to go ahead and select the ISO image. And I've already selected the one that I want to use for Server 2012. And you're just going to click Next. From here, it's going to ask you for a product key. You don't have to put that in. It's just so that it'll activate for you. This is going to be the version to install. You don't have to select any of this really. I'm just going to bypass this. And it's going to prompt you that you didn't enter a product key, and it'll install without one. And we're just going to click yes to continue. From here, you can name your server. I'm going to add R2 to it. And you can also add the location of where you want the virtual machine to be stored. And when you click next, you're going to get a disk capacity. You're going to, the first option is how big you want the virtual disk to be. And recommended size for this Windows Server 2012 is 60 gigs. I haven't really seen that change much from OS to OS. So I think the standard is 60 gigabits. But we're just going to leave it like that. There's two different options down here. One's to store the virtual disk in a single file, and one's to split it up. If you split it up, it makes it a little easier to move the virtual machine if you want to install it on another computer. The only downside is when you get into a higher the higher amount or the larger the disk, it may be a little bit hindrance on your performance, but we're going to keep it that because it shouldn't get anything higher than 60 gigs. It should probably be less, but it's not a big deal. We're just going to click next there. And here you're going to see all the details of the virtual machine that you made. Now you do have the option to customize hardware here, and when you do that, you should see some options on the left, anywhere from memory processing to the CD-ROM drive if you want to change that, if you want to change your networking. I usually bridge the connection to my physical adapter so that I don't have to worry about anything else. You can do a whole bunch of stuff though, there's really no limit to that. So. You can select the USB controller, sound, you can have different printer settings and a couple display settings, but that's pretty much. We're going to leave it at 2 gigs. That's the recommended for my system, so we're just going to close out of this. And I'm going to uncheck the option for power on this virtual machine after creation, and I'm going to click finish. And you'll see that this is the new one that we just started right here. I probably should have named it something differently because of the fact that we've already got one, but it's not a big deal. The first thing we're going to do is boot it up. So you just want to either right click it, or up at the top you can click the little green arrow and power on. Okay, from here it's just going to load the files. You may get this message here. This message is just because of the VM tools. I usually don't install them until I actually get done installing the OS, so just click remind me later. And inside of this window here, you're gonna see all the different options for the virtual machine. Here's the player information. You can select removable drives or whatever you want there. You can suspend it, control delete, enter full screen mode, or Unity mode. So you'll see that it's actually just taken off, and there's really no need for me to do anything more but to let it go. It's just like a standard installation, so there's not much more to that. If you have any questions about this, let me know. It's really that easy. So, thanks for tuning in, and you guys have a wonderful day.